Let's consider the classic mammography problem as it appeared in Eddy's article in 1982. The probability that a woman at age 40 has breast cancer is 1%. The probability that the disease is detected by mammography is 80%. The probability that the test misdetects the disease, although the patient does not have it, is 9.6%. So, if a woman at age 40 is tested as positive, what is the probability that she indeed has breast cancer? Now, we could find the exact answer if we want, but this is not what happens in real life. In real life, we just need a good approximation. So, considering this, which one of these do you think is correct? Is it 0 to 30%? Is it 30 to 60%? Or is it 60 to 100%? Well, the correct one is 0 to 30%. And this is because the exact answer is a mere 7.8%. Even doctors get this wrong, and in a study, 95% of the doctors said that the answer is between 70 to 80%. But why is the correct answer so low? We could explain this using Bayes' theorem, but it's not intuitive, so we'll use visualizations instead. We know that 1% have cancer, so if the dots represent women, then the pink are women with cancer and the blue are women without cancer. Now the women go off to do a mammography, and 80% of the women with cancer get a positive mammography. Similarly, 9.6% of the women without cancer also get a positive mammography. Now Barbara got a positive mammography, so she must be one of the women in the black group. So, the probability that she is a pink dot within the black group and that she really has breast cancer is a mere 7.8%. This brings us back to the 7.8% we showed earlier on.